The Climate and Weather Project is the big cumulative lab project for the quarter. In it, you will apply the concepts that we have covered over the past weeks. Because this is such a big project, I've broken up the introductory videos into four parts. Please note that watching these videos does not replace reading the project handout. These are intended to supplement and clarify the handout. In this video, we will go over the expectations and materials required. The next video will look at what things to consider when picking where to set up your thermometer and how the surroundings will affect the temperature readings. In the third video, we will look at how to collect and enter your data for the class dataset and complete the class discussion. In the fourth video, we will talk about collecting 5 days of data for your own analysis, what to consider in your write-up, and what you need to turn in. You should plan ahead to spend 2 weeks working on this project. I suggest that you watch all four videos now to get an idea of what is required, then go back and review each one as needed. Keep in mind the goal of this project is not perfect data collection. The goal is to consider a real-world data set and to have thoughtful analysis and apply what you have learned in class. There are several deadlines for this project. You need to collect data on one of two dates. You need to enter the data into the class data set. You need to participate in the class discussion. And finally, you need to turn in the project write-up. Deadlines for each of these are listed in the syllabus and in the project handout. Each deadline has points associated with it, so you need to pay attention to each one. Let's take a look at what you will need to do this project. First, you will need to set up your thermometer and collect data. One of the dates that you collect data needs to be one of the dates that everyone in class is required to collect data. Check the project handout and the class announcements for the exact date. The data will then go into a class map that you will use as a basis for a class discussion about microclimate patterns in the Bay Area. Next, you will need to collect 5 days of data in a row. Enter your data into a spreadsheet and graph it. Then answer a bunch of questions about the patterns you notice in the data and compare it to the class data set. Finally, you will need to take a picture of your thermometer and its setup. You turn this in twice, once to the class discussion posting and then with your assignment write-up. You do not need much in the way of equipment to complete this project. First, you will need a thermometer. There are many different types that will work for this project. You can pick up an inexpensive bulb thermometer at your local hardware store for less than $5. The thermometer on your car dashboard that shows the outdoor temperature will also work. The weather app on your smartphone or your computer is not a thermometer. Do not use this. You will need a digital camera, such as the one on your phone, to take pictures of your thermometer. You will also need a copy of Microsoft Excel or another spreadsheet software to record and graph your results. Okay, that's it for this video. The next video will go over how your thermometer's surroundings will affect its temperature reading. Happy trails!